Hello, and welcome to the Heidelberg Academy's presentation of Achieving the Optimal OCT Image. My name is Tim Steffens, and I'm Manager of Field Application Support. Today we're going to discuss a few different things. First, I'd like to discuss a couple of assumptions that we're going to make regarding this webinar. Second, I'll discuss the acquisition differences between Heidelberg's two OCT models. Third, I'll discuss the details of the acquisition window. Then I'll discuss the alignment of the photographer, camera, patient, and OCT optimization. Lastly, I'll discuss how to acquire an optimal volume and RNFL scan. First, I'd like to discuss the assumptions. In this webinar, we're going to automatically assume that you know how to turn on the instrument, enter the patient data, and select the device type. If you do not know how to do this, you have resources on your SPECTRALIS, or you can go online and download the SPECTRALIS Instrument Training Guide. The basic difference between the two models of OCTs that we have are pretty simple. One model has a touch panel that is used for acquisition. You can also use the foot pedal for acquisition. The image here on the left with the acquire button is the touch panel itself. So when you're ready to take a picture, you would press the acquire button. The touch panel models also are manual brightness. The brightness is adjusted by dialing the black gain control knob at the bottom of the touch panel under the acquire button. In this example here, you can see where it says sensitivity. It is set at 59. This number can be adjusted higher or lower just by spinning the black gain control knob. The other model, the OCT only model, the joystick is used for acquisition itself. Here you can see that there is a button on top of the joystick. And the brightness is also set to automatic. The brightness of the fundus image is controlled through the device itself, whereas again on the touch panel, acquisition is controlled by the user. To turn on the tracker for the touch panel model, you also have to press the black gain control button on the touch panel. For the joystick acquisition model, you hold the joystick button down for 1 second and that will activate the eye tracker. To take the picture, you just press the joystick button very quickly, just once, and that will start acquisition. This is what the acquisition window interface looks like when you're ready to take an OCT image. In the bottom left-hand corner, there is a box called Settings. In that Settings box, there are a couple of different things I'd like to discuss. There is the left and right eye. So when you move the camera back and forth between the two eyes, it will automatically indicate which eye you're imaging. The angle of view is 30 degrees. Whenever you're going to take OCT images, it should say 30 degrees. The focus setting for this particular patient here is set at -2¾ of a diopter. When you focus the fundus image, that focus setting will be fairly close to the patient's refraction. But we really don't concern ourselves with what that number actually is. When we focus the HRA image or the fundus image, we always want to focus on the brightest image of the fundus. We don't want to focus on the blood vessels and how sharp they might or might not be. We always want to focus on brightness because this is a confocal system, and the brighter the image is of the fundus, the more focused we will be. And you can see that this model here is a touch panel model because of the sensitivity number. It says 59 and it does not say auto next to it. Next, I'd like to discuss the structure and application section here, right in the middle of the screen. If you notice, now it is set to glaucoma. If you press that button, you will also get another pull-down menu that says retina. This button here brings up a different set of presets for each application and structure. So these presets here are for glaucoma, and these are the presets for retina. Both set of application and structure, whether it's glaucoma or retina, will have 4 different custom buttons. The last thing we'd like to discuss is the scan window. In the scan window, you can see that there are a couple of different things that you can adjust the OCT scan for. The first one is the art frames. If we press the fast scan as our preset, we select that as our preset, whether it's in the glaucoma setting or under the retina, the art frames will be 9. We can artificially adjust those art frames higher or lower. Well, why would we want to do that? If we have a patient that doesn't fixate very well, they have very severe macular degeneration, or just very severe eye problems and they cannot fixate, we may want to move that art frame from 9, which again is the preset for the fast, maybe down to 5 or down to 3, so that it's a little bit easier for the patient and the test runs a little bit smoother. Next to it, you can see that there is an angle. We can also angle any of our scans, volume scan or line scans, anywhere between 0 and 90 degrees. So you can see that this single line scan in this picture here is just horizontal. We can also just press this button and go straight vertical. The fast scan itself, again, is a 20 by 20 degree box. I can make that box bigger or smaller here by pressing the plus or the minus buttons. I can make it bigger or I can make it shorter or longer by pressing this on the side, the plus or the minus. The number of sections is the number of B scans per volume scan. So right now we're set at 97, and I can make more B scans by pressing the plus or fewer B scans by pressing the minus button. Next, I'd like to discuss photographer alignment. And what I mean by this is the way that you sit at the camera. I see a lot of people sitting like this at the camera itself, which is a very poor imaging position. If you're doing a lot of OCTs throughout the day, which some of you do, to avoid neck and back problems, you're turning your head, which is not a very comfortable position. What I'd like you to do is actually to turn your body and face the monitor. This is a pretty good position here. I actually like to sit more on the corner of the camera, really where his elbow is. Right here is about where I actually put my chair. And if you'll notice, he has one hand placed on the column of the Spectralis, the other hand is on the joystick. If he needs to let go of the joystick to grab the mouse, the touch panel, or even focus on the back of the camera, right, his one hand will always be on the camera itself. So if the patient is moving around or they're having a hard time fixating, he can adjust the camera with that hand while at the same time focusing or using the touch panel or the mouse itself. Camera alignment and patient alignment. The most important thing to do is always to bring the patient to you. You don't want to have to go to the patient. If you start out with the camera too high and you're trying to take a picture and you ask the patient to open their eyes, what do they usually do? They open their eyes and they also open their mouth. So you run out of room. So what I like to do is adjust the joystick on the camera so that the column is centered right here on this red line. Now this red line is only available on the touch panel models. What I like to do for the OCT model is actually put my finger between this column here in the top and the base on the bottom, and if I put my index finger in there, I can touch the top and bottom of my index finger, and that's a good height to begin with there too. So you're right in the middle of that up and down movement. The next thing I like to do is to bring the patient's chin and the chin rest up or down depending on where their eye is in the window. So for example, in this patient here, the eye is very low, so I will bring the chin rest up to bring the patient's eye into the center of the screen or their pupil. Then the last thing I do is adjust the table for the patient's comfort. I know it's kind of strange, but patient comfort always comes last for me. Image optimization. Here at Heidelberg, we like to call it flying the plane. The thing to take away here are these three basic concepts. Evenness of illumination of the fundus image. We always set up the fundus image first. Then focus on that fundus image. And remember, you always want to focus on brightness. And you'll see this in the videos coming up. But then saturation and density of the retinal pigment epithelium. So we'll just show a very simple example of how to fly the plane as I talked about earlier. So if you notice, this fundus image isn't very well evenly illuminated. The corners here are a little bit darker than they should be. And you'll notice that the retinal pigment epithelium here is not evenly dense. Since the OCT is ideally where we like it, in that top third of the window, we know we're set up exactly where we want to be. Now we just need to fly the plane. So if you think of the joystick as the joystick on a plane, if I move that left and right, that will move the OCT as if it's on a plane. So if I move it in one direction or the other, I go to the left here, you can see how it tilts the OCT. So we want to keep doing that back and forth ever so slightly until we get a nice clean image. So we have a nice even illumination on all four corners. We have good focus on our fundus image, and we have nice, good, even density or saturation on the retinal pigment epithelium. So here's a short little video on exactly what we're talking about. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to turn on the camera, and you may have to press the OCT button in the window there, or touch the IR OCT button on your touch panel. So once the camera calibrates, we'll put the patient's pupil in the center of the screen, and we'll start to move the camera forward. And here we pressed fast as our preset. As we move the camera forward, there we're in the center of the pupil. Now we're going to focus. If you notice, it gets dark there, and it gets a little bit brighter. And that's what we want, is we want the brightest image possible. We're going to move the camera forward a little bit more. And now we're going to move that joystick left and right. And you can see how the OCT tilts just as if it were the wings on a plane. We activate the eye tracker by pressing the black gain control button or holding down the joystick button for 1 second and then pressing acquire. We'll take those pictures. And then if you're satisfied with that, you can go to the other eye and do the same procedure all over again. So we're going to move the camera forward. We're going to focus here a little bit so it goes darker, goes brighter. The brightest image is what we like. Move the base of the camera forward a little bit more, and we can adjust the joystick left and right to get that nice even saturation on the RPE. Activate the eye tracker and press acquire. Again, the eye tracker on the touch panel is a black gain control, or on the joystick, let's hold that button down for 1 second. Once we've acquired our images, we always want to click Save Images and then exit. And there are our two images, one for the left eye and one for the right eye. So now what I like to do is talk about acquiring a volume scan again. So we're going to go through these steps one more time. We're going to break it up into smaller chunks so it's a little bit easier to digest. So again, we're going to turn on the camera, and we've already assumed that you've entered the patient's data in. Once the camera's turned on again, we want to press either IR OCT in the touch panel, or you may have to press OCT there on the screen. We're going to wait for it to calibrate. Once the system calibrates, you'll see that by the snow here in the OCT window. Then we're going to select a preset scan, and here we're going to select fast again. We're going to line the patient up with their chin and the chin rest, adjust the chin rest up or down, and as we push the camera forward, we want to fill that fundus window with the image of the fundus itself. And then we're going to focus. If you notice, there's that little bright pop of light that we saw, and that's what we like to see. The brighter the image, the more focused we are. And you want to make sure that you're centered in the middle of that pupil. The more centered you are, the brighter it will also be. We're going to slide the base of the camera forward a little bit more. As we slide it forward, there comes our OCT. Now we're going to fly that plane. We're going to adjust the joystick left and right a little bit to get a nice, even density on the retinal pigment epithelium. I'm going to fly that plane. There we go. And then once we're satisfied with that optimal saturation, we're going to activate the eye tracker by pressing that black gain control knob or holding down that joystick button. And we know that the eye tracker is on because of these two images down here in the bottom. If those two images are on, the eye tracker has been activated. Once it's been activated, we can take the picture by hitting acquire on the touch panel or by just pressing the joystick button very quickly. And then we're going to go up to save images and exit again. Or you can go to the other eye and test the other eye. Or if there's, if you want to take a picture of the optic nerve, you can take a picture of the optic nerve. All right, now I'd like to discuss acquiring an RNFL scan. When acquiring an RNFL scan or even a macular scan where the patient doesn't fixate exactly in the center, we always want to activate the eye tracker first and then move the scan. The reason we do that is because that fundus image will stay perfectly still and we can move the scan exactly where you want it to be. So again, we'll start by turning on the camera. And again, you may need to press IR OCT or the OCT button in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. We want to wait for the camera module, the OCT module, to calibrate. And there it's calibrated. This time we're going to go to glaucoma and we're going to select the RNFL scan. Some people also refer to it as the circle scan. We're going to line the patient up, push the camera forward into the patient's pupil. Once the fundus becomes visible, we want to make sure that it's centered in the screen. We're going to focus the camera here. You'll see it'll get a little bit bright, the patient blinks, and we're already in focus. Again, we're going to slide the camera forward until the OCT becomes visible. We're going to adjust our joystick left and right. On the circle scan, you may have to spin the joystick even a little bit to get it more evenly illuminated or even density across the RPE. And then we're going to activate the eye tracker. And when we activate the eye tracker, the fundus image will become perfectly still. And then I can move the scan exactly where I want to, over the optic nerve or over the fovea if you're trying to center a volume scan on the center of the fovea. The most important thing here whenever centering the RNFL scan is to make sure that you have the same amount of retinal tissue at 12 o'clock as you do at 6 o'clock and 3 o'clock and 9 o'clock. All right, so that you have a nice even circle all the way around, that you're measuring the same amount of tissue on all four sides. What do you do if the disc is tilted? You do the same thing. You try to measure if this disc was tilted. Right? I would want to make sure that if the disc was maybe shaped a little bit more like this, I'd want to make sure that I had the same amount of tissue from here to here. So say maybe at 11 o'clock and 5 o'clock, and also between say 7 o'clock and 1 o'clock. You have that same amount of tissue. Just do the best that you can. It might be a little bit more challenging, but just do the best that you can. Once you activate the eye tracker, press the button, acquire button once, and you'll take a picture. And if you notice down here, we've taken two pictures. Again, once you take the picture, you can click Save Images and exit. The other thing to be mindful here is once you do activate the eye tracker, make sure that you let the ART frames build up to 100. All right? Sometimes it may not get to 100 if you have patients that have a difficult time fixating, but let it build up as much as it can. The more ART frames you build up, the better the overall image will look. Just remember, the most important things are to make sure that your fundus image is evenly illuminated, that you have good focus, which again is brightness, and that you have nice even density along the retinal pigment epithelium. To activate the eye tracker, push the black gain button on the touch panel or hold down the joystick button for 1 second. To actually take the picture on the touch panel, press acquire or use the foot switch. On the joystick model, just press the button really quick and you'll start to take your pictures. Thank you very much for viewing this webinar. If you have any questions, you can phone our technical support hotline at 800-931-2230 and press option number 2. There's also online support at heidelbergengineering.com. There are clinical tools, articles, guides, reports, and other webinars that are available. You can also email us at clinicalusa@heidelbergengineering.com. This concludes the webinar, Achieving an Optimal OCT Image.